Hello, welcome back to my channel. So I want to talk about Rachel and Doug in this video, but first I want to talk about the deleted scene that WeTV uploaded to their YouTube channel. And I don't know why they didn't show this in an episode, but it's Rachel and she invites her friends over and she's freaking out because her friends show up and Doug's still not there. And I guess Doug borrowed her car for the day because it was his first day at work and he got a job doing CNC machinery. And so Rachel is glad that Doug got a job. She has her friends over there, but she's wondering where the heck Doug is because he's running late. Finally, Doug shows up. But he did not make a good first impression on Rachel's friends. He was acting like he's the king of the castle, and he really just needs to humble himself. Like Rachel's mom said, he really needs to remember where he came from, and he needs a slice of humble pie. So Rachel's friends come over to meet Doug. Doug's nowhere in sight. Rachel's freaking out because Doug's on an ankle monitor, and so he has to be home by 5 p.m., and he's cutting it awfully close, and Rachel just feels like he's playing with fire. And so she is nervous that Doug may not be able to beat his last track record of staying out of prison for more than 40 days, but she's really hoping so. So she's freaking out, and finally Doug walks in. He walks in like he owns the place. So Rachel's friend sits down with Doug and starts questioning Doug, and he's like, you know, do you really love Rachel? Do you guys think you're going to work out? He said, of course, she's too far invested, and he starts bragging about how she sent him 20 to 30 grand while he was in prison. It just gave me a bad taste in my mouth hearing him brag about it like that. And Rachel's friend said, of course she did. She has a history of doing that. She did that with her ex-husband because she's a fixer-upper. She sees the best in people. She wants people to reach their full potential. And I really feel that's what Rachel was trying to do with Doug, bring out the best in Doug. And then Doug had the nerve to say, well, if we don't work out, I appreciate her for fixing me. And had just this grin on his face. And I was just like, oh, man. Rachel just deserves so much better. I feel like this past two episodes, Doug's true colors have really came out and shown who Doug really is. But let's go ahead and talk about Doug and Rachel in the last episode. So they had that family drama. I felt so bad for Dougie Jr. He started crying and ran to Rachel, and Rachel embraced him. And Doug just continued yelling at his sister. He said that his sister is a very emotional person. She has very high highs and very low lows. So this sister, Doug's sister that I got in the fight with, she was dragging Doug's sister for the way she raised Dougie Jr. So Dougie Jr. ran to Rachel's car and started crying. And Doug jumped into the car with Dougie Jr. and demanded that Dougie Jr. talk to him. Dougie Jr. is like, I don't want to talk to you. Leave me alone. And Doug refused to leave him alone. He said, I'm not talking to nobody but Rachel. And I think that's pretty telling that Dougie Jr. wants Rachel to comfort him because she's probably the only one that's ever comforted him in a healthy way instead of just telling him to toughen it up like Doug was raised. So Rachel decided it was best if Doug Jr. and her got out of that environment they were in, because being around Doug's family was evidently toxic. And while Rachel was about to leave, and Doug's sister with the purple hair started telling Rachel, well, he's been lying to you this whole time. And she's like, how did he lie? And she said, just wait, if you bring him anywhere near Kalamazoo, he's gonna lie, he's gonna cheat on you, and he's gonna end up right back in prison. And Doug's sister was trying to warn Rachel, if he starts effing up, you need to get far away from him. He's going to drag you down with him. And she was saying, he's a dog. He's just going to use you. He has a bad track record of being a dog in his previous relationships. And she told Doug, don't worry, you'll be back in 2 months. And Doug snapped at her and said, well, you know, if somebody pisses me off, I might go back. And so Doug's sister got upset. She jumped on her boyfriend or husband's motorcycle and they drove off. So Rachel, Doug, and Dougie Jr. hop in Rachel's car, and Rachel was like, this is a lot. You have an effing anger problem. And Doug was like, well, if you bring me around that bee, then I'm gonna act like that. And Rachel was like, I don't even recognize who you are, and I just think the real Doug's coming out. And it was really sad because Dougie Jr., he was in tears and he was like, where was the kind, positive dad I thought I had? I knew you were strict, but I didn't know you yelled at your own family and said you don't need them. And Doug was like, I don't need them. And Dougie Jr.'s like, I need them. And, you know, that is a good point. You know, just because Doug has problems with his family, thus messing up Doug Jr.'s relationship with his extended family. And Doug told the producers that he loves Dougie Jr., but he's not going to baby him, and if he would have ever got in between any altercation between and his dad and another person, he says he would have been chopped and blocked just like the person his dad was getting an altercation with. And Doug tried telling Dougie Jr., you know, you don't like the way I treat you and the way I talk to you. Well, I definitely don't like the way that you effing talk to me. And I think Doug needs to have some empathy for his son, put himself in his son's shoes. And Dougie Jr. was crying in the back seat, so Rachel hopped in the back seat with him. And Dougie Jr. said, he's so much different than I anticipated. And Rachel said, you and me both. And then they cut to a scene from another day, and Doug's in Rachel's car calling his parole officer, saying that the power's out, and so there's a chance he can't charge his ankle monitor. And so then Rachel, she just walks in the house and turns on the breaker. And I was like, oh my gosh, what is this man good for? He can't even figure out how to just flip the breaker to turn the power back on. I thought, like, they were going to be screwed, and they were going to be sitting in the dark for a day or so. So Rachel and Doug sat down, and Rachel started talking to Doug, and she said she was concerned with the way that Doug was speaking to Dougie Jr., and Doug said, you know, I think we're still learning each other, trying to figure each other out, and Rachel said, I think we all are. And Doug said he was sad over the whole situation, how everything was handled the day before when he went to visit family. And so Doug just said, you know, that's just how I am. You know, I'm aggressive. I have an anger problem. And Rachel was like, yeah, but that's not cool. You know, that's not cool for Doug Jr. And Doug's like, well, that's how I was raised. You know, I was raised when the adult talks, you shut up and listen. And Rachel made a fantastic point. She said, you have to stop the cycle. You have to break the cycle. If he doesn't stop the cycle, then who is? You know, Rachel explained to him, if you keep speaking to Dougie Jr. this way, then you're going to break him. And then Doug was like, well, didn't you hear him tell me to F off yesterday? You know, when Doug was trying to console Dougie Jr., he's like, F off, I want Rachel. And Rachel was like, yeah, because he was upset. And Doug was like, I was upset too. But the difference is, you are the adult, Doug. You're supposed to be the one setting the example to Dougie Jr. So you can tell when Doug gets upset, he automatically stops listening and all rationality goes out the window. And he tries to use the excuse that he went to prison because he got mad and angry. And he says, well, if I get angry and go punch your neighbor, does that make it right? Which I'm not sure what point he's trying to make there. But Rachel's like, no, it doesn't make it right. And Rachel's like, you know, you just need to listen. And Doug was like, how can I listen when he tells me to F off? So Rachel was just so frustrated. You could tell she was just like grinding her teeth together, so irritated. And Doug said, you know what? Dougie Jr. has been getting away with too much for too long. And Doug took responsibility for part of that. He said, it's my fault because I wasn't there, but it's about time that he starts listening to me. So Rachel was like, you know, we gotta figure out a better way to communicate as a family. This can't keep going on the way things are going on. So she recommended that they all go to family therapy. And Doug started laughing and making a joke out of it. And he said he hadn't seen a counselor since third grade. He had to go see a counselor. And she got psyched out by him. So she sent him to the supervisor. And she got psyched out by him, he alleges. So he ended up not doing counseling. And Rachel made a good point, you know. She said that Doug talks to his son the way that you shouldn't be talking to a 11-year-old boy who hasn't had his father in his life or his mother. And Doug's gonna kill any spark left that Dougie Jr. has. And Doug tries to act like therapy's never helped him. When he did go to therapy, they ended up prescribing him Ritalin. He ended up never taking it. And Doug claims he didn't need therapy growing up. He needed his parents and needed more one-on-one time with them. And he says he knew his parents loved him, but he wasn't ever watched and was rarely shown attention. So Rachel says she thinks it'd be a good idea for a third person to sit from the outside looking in and to give them some therapy and help them be able to figure out a better way to communicate amongst each other. And Doug was like, why do I need a therapist when I have a wife? And she's like, because you don't listen to me. And Doug's like, yeah, I do. And she's like, no, you don't. And Doug said, well, if I don't listen to the woman who gives me my four B's, then what makes you think I'm going to listen to this overpaid mother effer talking about the therapist? And Rachel was saying the counseling needs to happen, the communication needs to happen, or it's going to make or break Dougie. And Doug got mad and clapped back and said, you ain't going to give me no freaking ultimatum. Then Rachel started talking about having a baby, and Doug said, you are not about to give me no ultimatum about a baby either. So Rachel's trying to be patient with Doug because she knows that he just got out of prison. He's trying to reintegrate back into society and all that, but her patience is running thin. So Rachel, she pretty much told Doug, you know, get with the program or get the F out. And Doug said, you are not about to tell me what to do. You cannot expect me to just wake up and be a different person. This is me. And like I keep saying, he's showing who he really is, who what his true colors really are. So Rachel's like, I think this conversation's done. She walked off and she did not look happy. I think the last thing they need to do is mix a baby up on this mess. Like, I'm absolutely confident in Rachel, but I don't have one bit of confidence in Doug being a good father role model and sticking around. Like, we already know, spoiler alert, Harem and Rachel are no longer together. She filed for divorce back in November or December. She didn't follow through, but she filed for divorce again back in June, and I'm pretty sure she's following through with it this time because Doug has a new girlfriend that he's been with since May. So that's it for this video. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Make sure you give this video a thumbs up. Make sure you enter my giveaway. It's the last day for my giveaway. The link is in the description. And thank you for watching.